Hey everyone, it's Justin again. Before we can learn how to graph quadratic functions, we have to understand a key algebraic property, the zero product property, which is a major factor, pun intended, in why parabolas look the way they do. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to apply the zero product property to find root of a quadratic function. To obtain that skill, we'll first review the zero product property, expanding it to polynomials, and then we'll define what roots are. Finally, we'll work through some examples of how to find roots using the zero product property. You technically already know the zero product property. The zero product property states that the product of zero and any other value is always zero. Zero times any other number, zero. Zero times a variable, zero. Zero times an entire polynomial? Distribute the zero, which makes each term become zero, and a bunch of zeros added together is still zero. But the most important implication of the zero product property, especially when it comes to quadratics, has to do with binomial factors. If we find a way to make either of the factors zero, then by the zero product property, the product will automatically be zero. But how do we make one of the factors zero? By using the variable. We could find a value for x that causes the factors to become zero. So if we want x minus 2 to be zero, x would have to be 2. 2 minus 2 is 0. The same way, if we want x plus 3 to come out 0, we can use negative 3 because negative 3 plus 3 makes 0. We call these two numbers, 2 and negative 3, zeros. Not like the number 0, but as in these cause the function to become 0. If the name zeros is too confusing, or if you're just tired of hearing me say the word zero, you can also call these the function's roots. So what are the roots of this function? The roots will be the values of x that can cause any factor to zero out. So let's take the factor on the left. We set it equal to zero and solve, finding that x is negative 4. You can do the same with the second factor. Just takes more steps, and eventually we get that x has to be 3/2. These two values are the roots. If we input either negative 4 or 3/2 for x, one of the factors will simplify to zero, making the output for the entire function zero. Some functions have more than two factors, but that doesn't change anything. Each factor will have a root. Pause the video now and see if you can find all the roots for this function. For each factor, we set them equal to zero and solve. So these are the roots you should have gotten. But wait, does something seem off to you? The same root appears multiple times. If a root appears multiple times, we say it has multiplicity. Since negative one is a root twice, instead of listing it twice, we just say negative one with multiplicity two. And of course, if the function isn't factored, you'll have to factor it before you can use the zero product property. Let's see how well you remember the last unit. Pause the video, factor this quadratic function, and then find its roots. We can use the basic factoring method for this one. Two numbers that multiply to make negative 12 but add together to make negative 1 are negative 4 and 3. Now that it's factored, we can find the roots, 4 and negative 3. This whole lesson, we've been using the zero product property and finding the roots of polynomials, but what's it all for? Well, roots are used to graph higher degree functions. And now that you know how to find roots, the next video will be all about using those roots to graph quadratic functions. See you then.